Good day. Welcome to this Nuggets of Truth. We are so grateful to come to you today. We are coming from Bethel Tabernacle Empowerment Center in Sans Souci. I am Dr. Emmanuel McLaurin, sharing with you on this Nuggets of Truth. I want to share with you about using the currency of heaven. And if you are going to be savvy in your operation in business in certain currencies and certain places, you have to have the right currencies. If certain nations, we're so grateful that for the US dollar, it has quite a latitude and it can be used in many places. But there are some places that if you're going to do business, you will have to have the right currency, the currency of that nation, and to be effective to all levels of business. And so without the right currency, you can get yourself in trouble. There are some places that some of the currencies of the world, they are not able to be exchanged for other monies because of its weakness and its difficulties. And so we have some nations like this. So currencies are very important. In the spiritual realm, the currency of heaven is faith. The Bible tells us that without faith, it is impossible to please God. And the Bible explains very clearly, if we're going to receive anything from God, from His kingdom, we're going to get the action of His Son and the Holy Spirit to work on our behalf, it must be done through faith, because the Bible explains clearly that without faith, it is impossible to please God. And he that cometh to God must believe that God is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. So it is important to come to this understanding and revelation that we need the currency of heaven. And sometimes people try to get to heaven using different currencies, and they try to use the religious affiliations. They try to use certain sense of religious rituals, and they felt through the much religious rituals and through the much chants and mantras and whatever they use, that this will get them access into heaven and get the answer of heaven. But the Bible tells us this is not the way we're going to get answers from heaven. We must use faith, because faith is the key. It opens the door to miracles and supernatural breakthrough. It is through faith that we can enter. The Bible tells us God Himself created the world through faith. And the Bible tells us through faith that that which we see was not made of things that did exist before, but God through faith called them into being and brought them into reality. So it is important to understand, if you're going to operate, and the Bible tells us he that cometh to God must believe. And it talks about in the book of James that the man who comes to God withering, and it's unwavering or wavering or unstable like the sea, don't think that this man, he says, will receive anything from God. Because if you're going to receive anything, it must be in the currency of the kingdom of heaven. And the currency is faith, that you got to use faith. The Bible even tells us when it comes to praying for the sick, you anoint them with oil, but the prayer of faith shall save the sick. The Bible speaks about praying in faith, believing, and you shall receive. Because as you pray in faith, believing, you shall receive. And you can bring from one realm to another realm. You can bring from the heavenly realms or the spiritual realm. You can bring what is already provided for you in that realm into this natural realm if you have faith. And the Bible tells us that faith is that currency. The Bible actually went further to say, the just shall live by faith. So it means the just, the person who is just, the person who is righteous, the person who is going to walk in, must live by faith, because faith is what's going to help you move forward. So the currency of heaven is faith, and you must use it to receive your miracle from God. It is important, as we look at the chapter in the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, it speaks of that whole chapter. It speaks of the faith heroes of the Bible, and it speaks of the Moses, when he got of age through faith, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, but rather suffer affliction with the people of God, because by faith he chose to be with the children of God and walk in the pathways. We spoken of Caleb, that warrior that went together with Joshua to spy the land. And the Bible says that this Caleb says, at 85 years, he said, give me this mountain. Remember Joshua and Caleb themselves, when they came back with the report from spying the land of Canaan, that the Bible tells us the other 10 that went with them gave an evil report. affirming that, yes, whatever God says is there, but we are not able to take, we are not able to have these people. And so what happened next, we saw that the people had was turned against God. But Joshua and Caleb, people of faith, believe, and they said, these people are bread for us. We can go and take it now. We can go and take what is ours. And they saw, through faith, God give them the promised land. The Bible speaks of Abram, the father of faith, who called the things that are not as though they are through the faith of God. And we saw that he used the currency of the kingdom of God, and God would not allow him to get anything otherwise than through the currency of the kingdom. And so the Bible tells us that Abraham had to believe God against all hope. He had to believe that even the deadness of the womb of his wife Sarah and the deadness of his own loins, that he had to believe that God was able to do this and give him a child at that age. He believed God and used the currency of heaven. He used the currency of heaven and received miracles and breakthrough from God. So I want to say to you today that if you're going to receive from God, from heaven, from the kingdom of God, you got to use the currency of the kingdom of God, and you must operate based on that currency. You must walk in one of the principles of the kingdom, which is one of humility, that as we humble ourselves, God will exalt us in due time. But we got to believe that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above what we can even think or ask. So faith must rise in us. If we can believe God, we will see the miracle power of the living God. We will see God working on our behalf and giving us breakthrough. But you will need to use the currency of the kingdom of God. You cannot use any other currency. You cannot use, because God will not respond. Sometimes people feel through, and though God is touched with the feelings of our infirmity, though God is touched by what we go through, but God only responds to faith. So he touches you, pouring you all of the wine and wound you, and help your wounded soul. But if you're going to receive from God, you still got to go back to the place where you put your faith and confidence in God, because without faith, you cannot please God. And so you got to put faith and trust in the God of heaven and believe God to turn things for you. The Bible tells us that Elias was a man of like passion as we are. But the Bible tells us in the book of James, chapter 5, that he prayed that it would not rain, and it did not rain. And he went and prayed again that it would rain, and did rain. So he said, if Elijah operated by the currency of the kingdom, which is faith, and he's a man of like passion as we are, we must operate by the currency of the kingdom. Whatever you need from God, you must believe that God will do it. Whatever you believe in God to do and intervene in your life, God will turn things around and give you the miracle that will blow your mind if you can believe God. But you must believe God. Against all hope, you must believe God. Your heart must be prepared with faith to believe God. You must trust in God with everything that you have and see God open doors for you and give you the miracle that you need today. I want to encourage your heart today. You might be going through a difficult, challenging moment in your life, and you might even think of giving up. And I was, I've been talking to people, different kind of people facing different challenges. And I was just talking to a young man who ready to give up on life. I'm very young man with a family, but yet the pressures of life were so much that he had lost faith and confidence in God, and he had lost faith in leaving, and he had faith in God to leave. And so I had to help him understand, you can put your trust in God, trust God, he'll able to help you and bring you through. So today I'm saying, Oliver, to say, whatever you are going through, whatever your challenges are and difficulties are in this moment of your life, you need faith, but you cannot use no other currency, neither pity party, neither crying and tears. All these are important, good emotional release, but it's your faith have to be exercised. You got to exercise your faith to receive the miracle and to have the breakthrough that is yours. Unless you exercise faith, nothing changes. You will exercise faith and God will bring to you that which is lacking. And today, if you are looking and you say, Pastor, what must I do? Faith, trust God, believe God, speak the things that God has already declared concerning you. And as you speak it, see God open the doors and give you the miracle that you need in your life. I want to pray with you today, because I believe God wants to do something awesome for you. I believe that God wants you, but I'm here to encourage you. I'm here to say to you, you got to use the currency of the kingdom. I'm here to say to you that you need to put your faith, and you got to exercise your faith. Because so many times, because of lack of faith or a lack of persistency, that we begin our journey in trusting Christian and believe in God. But down the road, down the line, all of a sudden, we lose faith in God. And we put faith in people and things and materials. And sometimes all of this will fail us. We are reminded that even the great David, the great warrior, who did not trust in his own armor, and neither the armor of Saul, but he trusted in God to help him through the great Goliath and to destroy the Goliath. This David says that some trust in chariot, some in horses, but I will remember the name of the Lord, because he said the arm of flesh will fail you, but if you trust in the Lord and do not lean unto your own understanding, and in all your ways you acknowledge him, he will direct your path. So trust in the Lord and minister. Let God minister to you and change your life today and give you peace and freedom, if you would. I want to pray with you today. Those of you who have come to join us, all over you have joined with us, we pray that God would minister to you. Remember, you need to use the currency of the kingdom. You need to use your faith and believe God to give you the miracle that you need. And so thank all of you that have come here. I believe that God is doing something awesome today, and I want to pray for that change to come. I want to pray for God to shift things in your life and realign you and position you for greatness. Greatness is ahead of you. Miracle is ahead of you. Breakthrough is ahead of you. Whatever you need from God, God wants to do it for you today. If you can trust him, he will give you the miracle. All you need is faith in God. Are you ready to put your faith in God? Are you ready to put your confidence in God? Are you ready to declare and decree and to see the things that you need come to pass today? Bow your heads with me in prayer wherever you are, because this is your moment that God will open the door for you and give you the miracle. Let us pray now. Whatever your needs are, just mention it before God where you are. If you're sick in your body, lay your hands on that body part and let's believe God for your miracle. Let's believe God to shift and align and position you and bring you to a place of victory and breakthrough. Shall we pray? Father, I just want to thank you for each one of these precious ones that are looking at. We thank you for your grace upon them. I thank you because you are the mighty healer. You are able to do exceedingly abundantly above what we can even think or ask. And so today, by your Holy Spirit, I pray that the anointing and the power of God would flow through and touch your people today. Help them, O God, to put their faith and trust and confidence in you, that they will not trust in the arms of flesh. We bind all hindrances and blocks and barriers, every chain, every net, every system that have been set to prevent them from going forward, this man, this woman. Minister, Lord, let the anointing of God reach their homes, touch them in the vehicle, wherever they are at this moment, and turn things around for them, for the good Lord. So we declare a blessing over them. Let your miracle power flow. Even now we pray in Jesus' name. Remember, use the currency of the kingdom of heaven. Put your faith in God. You don't have much challenges as you think, because if you use the currency of the kingdom, God will turn things around for you. But you need to use your faith and trust God to give you a miracle. Remember, we are coming from Bethel Tabernacle Empowerment Center in San Jose. Dr. McLaren sharing with you. Let us know if this has been a blessing to you, these messages and the many messages we send for the course of the week. Let us know. Share it with your friends and let us know how we have been a blessing to you. Remember, you can join us this evening. We have miracles, signs, and wonder service at 6:30 at Bethel Tabernacle in San Jose. At 6:30, welcome you. May God bless you.